Just like any other religion, Buddhism also has a lot of historical and sacred places. The land on which Gautam Buddha walked is considered sacred even today. The story of these sacred places is so ancient that the history and rumors have combined to form a story. The monuments here don't just talk about Buddha, but the tales of their followers as well. The Buddhist circuit is spread from North India right up to West Nepal. The Buddhists travel from countries far and wide to India just to see these historical places associated with the life of Gautam Buddha. For the 500 million Buddhists around the world, the journey is very spiritual. Buddha had advised his followers to visit these religious spots while he was alive. The circuit is visited not just by Buddhists, but by people of all religions due to its universal appeal. The monuments present here don't just belong to the Buddhists, but to the entire world. Buddhist circuit gives importance to the significant places in the life of Buddha. This includes four sacred places, Bodh Gaya, Sarnath, Kushinagar and Lumbini. The importance of all these places was actually taught to the world by Ashoka the Great. First, he visited all these places himself and then built mandir and stupas there. And hence, people started visiting these places. Located 10 kilometers away from Varanasi, Sarnath is the birthplace of Buddhism. It is said that Buddha chose this place because of the greenery and the peace it offered. In those times, this place was called Rishipattan or Mrigadaya. Jataka tales tells us the story about Buddha living here as a deer in one of his past lives. Even today, one can spot a lot of deers in this place. After enlightenment, Buddha gave his first sermon to five of his disciples in this place itself. Today, this place has a stupa called Chokhandi. It is said that about 2500 years ago, it was this sermon that turned the Buddhist wheel of religion. This wheel of religion spread in various countries and spread both dharma along with it. Soon after this, Buddhist Sangha was established. Buddham Sharanam Gacchami, the birthplace of this Buddhist mantra, is also Sarnath. Here is a stupa called Dhamik, which was considered as the throne of Buddha. Built in the 5th century AD, Dhamik Stupa was a 128 feet tall and 93 feet wide structure, the ruins of which can be seen even today. Behind it is the Mulganthakutti Temple. Huan Sang has mentioned about it in his book. It is said that Buddha used to rest and meditate in this temple. After accepting Buddhism, Emperor Ashok came here in 273 BC and he built a stupa on which there was a figure of a lion. This statue is today the national emblem of India. Yet another important place is Lumbini, which is now in Nepal, and along with it, Kapilavastu is considered to be the birthplace of Buddha. For many years, Buddhists knew that Buddha was born in Lumbini, but nobody knew where it was. This place was discovered in 1886 by a British archaeologist. Today, the garden in which Buddha was born can be visited. Kenzo Tang, a Japanese sculptor, has decorated this place, and today it is a World Heritage Site. There is a temple dedicated to Buddha's mother Rani Maya nearby, and also a lake called Pushkarni. It is believed that Rani Maya had a bath in this lake before giving birth to Buddha, and Buddha had his first bath in this lake. Not only that, after Lumbini, Kushinagar near Gorakhpur in Uttar Pradesh holds an important spot in the Buddhist circuit. This is the place where Buddha let go of his body at the age of 80. He told his closest disciple Anand that he wanted to spend his last few moments near the Hiranyavati River. The Mahaparinirvana temple located here holds a 6-meter long statue of Buddha in which he is seen in the Parinirvana Asana. The statue made of black stone looks like it is made of gold because disciples have covered it with gold. This statue was made by a man called Haribala during the reign of King Kumar Gupta and sent here from Mathura in the 5th century AD. The place where Buddha let go of his body is the exact place where the Rambha Stupa stands today. There are a lot of stupas in Kushinagar. Mukutbandhana, Chaitya and Vihar were built by the Gupta kings. Kushinagar was also found in 1880 by a British archaeologist. There are a lot of Buddhist temples belonging to different countries in Kushinagar today. Kapilavastu is the place where Gautam Buddha grew up. The place which was known as Kapilavastu is now known as Piprava. And it is 20 kilometers away from the city of Siddhartha in North Uttar Pradesh. This was the place where Gautam Buddha's father, King Suddhodana, had a palace. Buddha left his palace at the age of 29 and returned after 12 years after being enlightened to meet everyone. There is a gigantic stupa standing here even today. It is believed that the stupa held the ashes of Buddha in olden times. Kaushambi is the place where Buddha frequently preached his sermons. He came here in the 6th and 9th year after obtaining Nirvana. Kaushambi was one of the six successful cities of India at that time. Shravasti was Gautam Buddha's place of choice in the monsoon. Buddha spent 24 monsoons in Shravasti. There is a small village called Gonda near Gorakhpur. Buddha's mother died just 7 days after his birth. But she often came to visit Buddha from the heaven. Sankhesa is the place where Buddha gave his mother Rani Mahamaya the gift of religion. Buddhism spread across India only due to the influence of the kings. The king of Maurya Ashoka and the king of Kushan Kanishk supported Buddhism and hence it spread in India. When the Gupta kings started favoring Hinduism, the hold of Buddhism started weakening in India. Upon not receiving support from the kings, Buddhism began to decline. People started accepting Brahmanical dharma, and after the spread of Islam in India, Buddhism slowly started to fade out. The big temples and religious places were not important anymore, and hence the Buddhist circuit lost its identity. But when the Buddhist circuit was again discovered in the 18th century AD, the curiosity among the people to visit these places and the will to follow Buddhism started growing again. Today, the Buddhist circuit offers the whole world an opportunity to experience the golden age of Buddhism in India. Buddhism gives a lot of importance to the footprints of Gautam Buddha. For many years, Gautam Buddha was idolized symbolically as his footprint. The footprints have a deep spiritual mission, which the people walking on the Buddhist circuit understand. These footprints are present in many places. By going there, in a way, we can all experience Buddha's journey called life.
Like, share, subscribe, and click on the bell icon to never miss an update from Epic.